Dear friends, welcome to this edition of VBS HistoMed, a component of the VBS Anatoma series on YouTube. Here we are discussing the histology of the lung. We will do it in several short videos. This is part one, where I am going to give you a few introductory concepts before moving into the detailed histology of the lung. Now, basically, what I'm going to do in this discussion is show you how the tracheobronchial tree is embedded. I mean more of the bronchial tree is embedded in the parenchyma of the lung. Then how the vessels are arranged and things like that. This is basically we will not be going into the detailed histology in this particular part one video, but the more details in subsequent videos. Let's take a look at this gross specimen of the lung. The surface that is being shown is the mediastinal surface. There are three arrows pointing to a small sample of the intrapulmonary bronchi. All of them are bronchi, intrapulmonary bronchi. The size varies because as the bronchi bifurcate into smaller and smaller ones, the size reduces as you go down the bronchial tree. This is about the orientation of the bronchial tree, how it goes into how the primary bronchus becomes secondary to tertiary to smaller bronchi. Several generations of this branching is shown here. Now, this is an interesting gross specimen. I have taken a horizontal cross section to show you how the lung parenchyma actually appears. Now, that is the serosa, that is whatever is the pleura that is lining the surface, the visceral pleura, let's say, lining the surface, and whatever dips into the major depressions, or what we call it as fissures. That's the visceral pleura, and inside what you can see is the visceral pleura cannot be separated from the rest of the lung or the because the connective tissue is closely plastered to this mesothelial membrane. The lung parenchyma is the way the bronchial tree is spread out, the vascular tree is spread out, the lymphatics are spread out, and how the local fibrous tissue is packed. Things, the whole thing gives you an appearance of a slice of bread, maybe. Now, this is another way of looking at the tracheobronchial tree. I have used a photograph. I will remove it from time to time and show you how, if I can use the silicon injection technique. I happen to have done one and it has come out well. Using this technique, we can actually bring out the bronchial tree in its complete detail. Now, what we do is once the silicon is injected into the tracheobronchial tree, the rest of the lung parenchyma is removed by dipping it for a long time in one of the strong acids. And at the end of it, we'll have to do some cleaning. And finally, this is how the tracheobronchial tree will look. You see, that's actually from a real lung I have been able to do it. You see, let's examine a few spots in this tracheobronchial tree to understand how the branching pattern is. Most of the textbooks, if you see, they would have used the word dichotomous branching pattern. I am showing you a few select spots where the branching of the bronchial tree is very, very clearly visible. Now, at the very end, maybe in this extreme areas, I just labeled it as lung parenchyma. That means this plus all the other tissues the immediate vicinity. Combined, we will call it as the lung parenchyma. Now, finally, we come to that the last part of the branching tree, a part where, you know, all the cartilages are gone, all the smooth muscles are gone, are slowly disappearing. Finally, you get the very, very terminal histological component, shall we say a functional unit or something like that, where the actual respiration takes place, or the where the air blood vessel interface is located. Now this is a diagrammatic representation. I will compare it with a histological view, a histological picture concurrently. Now you see, let's try to identify. We are at the very end of the bronchial tree. The alveoli are those blebs which you can see are very clearly seen. That's the atrium from which the alveoli pouch out, and you can see two alveoli have a common septum in between, and there are a lot of structures in that septum, and that's where the blood air barrier is also located. Next, when you look at the vascular architecture, it closely follows the bronchial tree. I, for example, labeled this red colored structure, mark my words, red colored structure, I have called it as a tributary to the pulmonary vein. Similarly, what is marked in blue, again watch my words, what is marked in blue is a branch of the pulmonary artery. I don't think I need to go into the details of why I have exchanged the color contrast. Well, it's well known. We will move to the next slide. Now you see, that's the smooth muscle becoming smaller and smaller until finally in the respiratory region, there is no smooth muscle whatsoever. This muscle is beautifully shown here, how the spiral arrangement of the smooth muscle is there in the bronchial tree. Now that's the vascular plexus. Now we will have a look at how the first component of this discussion, namely the intrapulmonary bronchus. Then we will go into the smaller and smaller histologically identifiable parts of, at least the cross sections of the different parts of the bronchial tree down the line. We saw the pulmonary bronchi in the previous gross specimens. Here is a cross section of one of these. Size may vary, but the design is the same in all the bronchi. Note in particular, there's a lot of cartilaginous pieces. That's a very signature feature of the intrapulmonary bronchi. Next, once the bronchi is over, we move to the next area, bronchiole, where the cartilage pieces are gone. Only a thick, a fairly thick smooth muscle covering or a sheath is there around the mucosa. And the mucosa continues to remain stratified, pseudo-stratified ciliated columnar. Next, terminal bronchiole. Thereafter, respiratory bronchiole. In that order, we will go. But before that, we will change the view or a field and take a field where almost everything can be seen in contrast with each other. And more important than the contrast is in continuity with each other. You'll have to search it out, but most lung slides will have one such area in longitudinal section. Now you see, here is one such area. You can see that's the bronchiole. Details we will discuss in subsequent videos. This is only an overall orientation. Terminal bronchiole, respiratory bronchiole. The signature feature here is the air-blood interface begins here, or respiration or oxygenation begins from here, because the lining is thin enough to facilitate that. Then we have the alveolar sacs, and finally the alveoli. Next, let's look at this bronchial tree in a slightly different footage. just like we have similar in the digestive, we have a modified thing in the these long tubes. There is a modification in the respiratory. The innermost layer is the mucosa. As we know, it has two components, a lamina propria and the surface epithelium. Surface epithelium, pseudo-stratified ciliated columnar epithelium. The lamina propria, loose connective tissue. Next, beyond the mucosa, next is the muscularis. That's what I told you, lot of smooth muscle fibers down to the last part of the bronchiole up to there, and maybe a little streaks here and there beyond that. Then the submucosa, and finally pieces of cartilage. Now the pieces of cartilage is unique to the bronchi. The moment the cartilage disappears, only the muscularis is left behind. Thereafter, the size of the bronchus is so small that we begin to call them as bronchioles. Next, we'll continue with the mucosa, surface epithelium and lamina propria. We have identified the epithelium resting on a basement membrane, and the lamina propria is located right below it, cellular loose connective tissue, and lymphoid tissue, bronchus associated lymphoid tissue will be seen here and there, although I have not shown in the photograph. Then the muscularis. This muscularis, as I showed you diagrammatically, has smooth muscle, but it is arranged not exactly circularly, but in a spiral, two spirals virtually 90 degrees to each other. So this is a very important point you need to remember, because in certain pathologies like bronchial asthma, the importance of this spiral architecture will become manifest. Next, the cartilage, once intrapulmonary stage is reached, the cartilage becomes discontinuous and small, in small islands you will see. Now that's very important, and in between the islands, collagen fiber bridges can also be seen. Number and the size of the cartilage aspect keeps reducing as you go down the bronchial tree. Finally, there is a spot where there is no cartilage at all. From that point onwards, the bronchus is relabeled as bronchiole. Now, there are a few bronchial glands that you will see. Just remember, they are helpful for the local secretions, both serous and mucus. Now, the location of these is important. They're located between the cartilages and outer to the muscularis. Now, this is very, very important submucosal location of the bronchial glands. Now, that was an overview of a few introductory concepts. Just to take you from the macroscopic feature or the gross anatomy of the lung that you see to slowly into smaller and smaller histological components of the tracheobronchial tree within the lung. So the next few videos we will go in detail for each of these signature items in a lung histological section. Thank you.